In this session, we'll try to discuss about one more structure which is present in the orbit, that is ophthalmic artery. See, this is ophthalmic artery. It is taking origin from the internal carotid artery. So, it is branched from the internal carotid artery, just medial to the anterior carotid process at the optic canal. Right? Along with optic nerve, this ophthalmic artery also enters into orbit through the optic canal. In the initial part of its course, it is present below and lateral to the optic nerve. These two structures are surrounded by common dural sheath. After passing some distance, it pierces the dura mater along the lateral part of the optic nerve. Then it ascends up along the lateral part of optic nerve. Then it crosses the optic nerve from lateral to medial side. So, it is crossing like this. Then, it runs along the medial wall of the orbit and at the medial part of eye, it will terminate after dividing into two terminal branches. Those are dorsal nasal branch and supratrochlear. Dorsal nasal and supratrochlear. So, this is the course of ophthalmic artery. Then, what are the branches? The main, first and important branch is central artery of retina. This central artery is first branch from the ophthalmic artery. First, this artery will be present below the optic nerve. Then, it runs some distance in between the optic nerve and dural sheath. When it reaches to 1.25 centimeters behind the eyeball, it pierces the optic nerve and it will passes within the substance of optic nerve. That means when you take the cut section at this level, you can see the optic nerve like this. Within the optic nerve, you can see the central artery of retina. Right? So, it passes within the substance of optic nerve and reaches to the optic disc where it will divides into branches. These branches will supply to the retina. This is the only branch which is supplying to the most of the retina, and it is end artery because it is not having any efficient anastomosis with the neighboring blood vessels. So, it is end artery and it is only artery to the retina. That's what if there is any blockage or any occlusion or any obstructions which leads to sudden blindness because there is no other arteries to supply the retina. Clear? So, that is about central artery of retina. This is central artery of retina. Then, largest branch from the ophthalmic artery is lacrimal artery. See, this is lacrimal artery. This lacrimal artery runs along the lateral part of the optic canal, just above the lateral rectus muscle. But this main trunk, it passes in between the superior oblique above and medial rectus below. That means in between the superior oblique and medial rectus, the main trunk is passing along the medial wall. And what is this? Lacrimal artery passes along the lateral wall above the lateral rectus muscle. Right? Then it runs forward and reaches to the anterolateral part of the orbit. And it will be supplying to the, what is this gland? Lacrimal gland. And it will supply to the lateral part of the palpebrae by giving palpebral branches. It will supply to the lateral palpebrae. That means lateral part of the eyelids by giving lateral palpebral arteries. Right? So, this is the course of lacrimal artery. Right? So, lacrimal artery is branched from the ophthalmic artery, runs along the lateral wall and reaches to the anterolateral part. There it will supply to the lacrimal gland and it will divide into lateral palpebral arteries. It will supply to the palpebrae. That means it will supply to the eyelids, conjunctiva and skin of the eyelids. Right? So, that is the course. Then what are the branches? Lateral palpebral branches. Then here, what is this? This is zygomatic artery. This zygomatic artery divides into zygomatic temporal and zygomatic facial. So these two arteries are passing through the corresponding foramen. That means this is zygomatic facial foramen, this is zygomatic temporal foramen. So through the zygomatic facial foramen, zygomatic facial artery will be passing, and through the zygomatic temporal foramen, zygomatic temporal artery is passing. Then here it will give one recurrent branch. This recurrent branch will be coming back through the upper part or lateral part of superior orbital fissure that we have discussed in the last session. Through the lateral part of superior orbital fissure, there will be passes of recurrent meningeal branch from the lacrimal artery. So this branch is coming back and anastomosing with the middle meningeal artery to supply meninges. Clear? So this is recurrent branch. And any other branches are there? Yes, muscular branches. So it will supply to the muscles. It will give muscular branches, right? So these are the branches. Recollect once again: branch to the lacrimal gland, lateral palpebral branches, zygomatic facial and zygomatic temporal arteries, recurrent meningeal branch and muscular branches, right? So that is about lacrimal artery. Then what are these? Posterior ciliary artery. This is what? Posterior ciliary artery. This posterior ciliary artery is branched from the main trunk of ophthalmic artery. It passes forwards, that means these branches will be passing forwards and pierces the sclera around the optic nerve, and they enters into the choroid, and it will supply to the choroid and iris, right? So that is about posterior ciliary arteries. Then anterior ciliary arteries. Actually, anterior ciliary arteries are not direct branches from the ophthalmic artery. They are branches from the muscular branches. Extraocular muscles having the blood supply, right? So from that blood vessels, anterior ciliary arteries are arising. Imagine this is muscular branch. From this muscular branch, anterior ciliary artery is arising and it is supplying to the eyeball. So that is about posterior ciliary and anterior ciliary arteries. Then what is this? This is supraorbital artery. What is it? This is supraorbital artery. This supraorbital artery passes the superior part of the orbit, and when it reaches to the supraorbital margin, see, this is supraorbital margin. At the supraorbital margin, it passes through the supraorbital notch or supraorbital foramen. Then it enters into forehead to supply the forehead and some part of scalp. So that is about supraorbital artery. Then what is this? Supratrochlear artery. The supratrochlear artery also winds around the supraorbital margin and enters into forehead and scalp to supply those structures, right? Then what is this? Dorsal nasal artery. Dorsal nasal artery, at the medial part of eye, it will supply to the nose and it will terminate after anastomosing with the terminal branch of facial artery, right? So it will anastomose with the facial artery. Here ophthalmic artery will give some medial palpebral arteries. These medial palpebral arteries will supply to the medial part of the eyelids, skin and conjunctiva, and they anastomose with the lateral palpebral arteries. Clear? Then what are these arteries? These are also branches from the main trunk of ophthalmic artery. So what are these? This is anterior ethmoidal artery, this is posterior ethmoidal artery, right? In the medial wall, these two foramens are there. What are these? Anterior and posterior ethmoidal foramens. Through these foramens, they passes and they supplies to the ethmoidal air sinuses, and they supplies to the nasal cavity also, right? So that is about anterior and posterior ethmoidal arteries. Clear? That's it about the branches of ophthalmic artery. Clear? So I hope you understood. That's it for this session.